Here we have a slide of skeletal muscle, and we'll notice when we look at it that the muscle is comprised of a lot of fibers, and these fibers are actual muscle cells. And the muscle cells, most of them run the entire length of the muscle, and so they can be quite long. And we can see that they have a striped appearance, and we call these individual stripes striations. A striation is a stripe, and these striations are due to the arrangement of protein filaments, and it's going to be the interaction of these protein filaments that are going to cause the contraction of the muscle. Now, we can also see that we have hundreds of nuclei for each muscle cell all along the periphery of the fiber. So it's very important to note that we have hundreds of nuclei all peripherally located, and the reason for this is that nuclei contain the DNA. The DNA provides the blueprint for proteins. So we have to have locally available nuclei along any part of the length of this muscle cell where it might need to conduct repairs and build more proteins. Indeed, some of these muscle fibers may be several centimeters in length.